There you are, chaps. Good morning and welcome back. Hope you're looking forward to another exciting day searching for clues amongst the pyramids. Fascinating things, aren't they? Ah, Dr. Sandyfoot, old chap.
Hello.
Goodness me, what's wrong with you? Well, what about on the wrong side of bed?
The wrong side of bed? I should think so. I was in my bed, all fine, just getting out, when all of a sudden, I came to bring you one of these when the tent collapsed. And when I managed to fight my way out, one of the tent ropes had gone. It'd been chewed up or something.
Well, who would do such a thing?
Well, that's what I thought. What a terrible thing to do. Anyway, got out of the tent, and then I saw Camilla standing there with one of the ropes. Guilty, I reckon.
Ah, well, yes, it might seem that way. Look, let's just have a look at this clue. You sit down, we'll get you a nice cup of tea.
Thank you.
So, chaps, you have a look at the clue in your pack. See if you can work out what the hieroglyphics mean today. I'll go and get Dr. Sandyfoot a nice cup of tea. I tell you what, old chap, let's get Marshall to cheer you up with that song he wrote, Made for This.
Mood. I got myself in a right old tangle with these tent ropes. Dr. Sandyfoot's tent collapsed on him. Someone had loosened the ropes. Hang on. Chewed on them. Well, he was furious and I got the blame. I was only trying to put the tent back up again. It wasn't me. I was trying to put it right. Oh well, hopefully he'll calm down and let me explain. Did you work out the clue? I did. Fair or unfair? Well, for me today it seems pretty unfair, but I wonder what that could mean for us. Meanwhile, Terry's got a game for you.
Welcome to today's challenge and game. We have Marshall and Tia with us who are going to try out our challenge today. Joseph was captured, and being captured is not always an easy life. So we thought we'd give Marshall and Tia the opportunity to see what it's like being captured and whether they can escape. Now, I've tied Tia up with a pair of fairly loose handcuffs. I'm about to tie Marshall up, but I'm going to tie him linked to Tia. And we'll tie him, it's fairly tight so that so as he can't go over his hands, but we're not tying them too tight to stop their circulation. So if you're trying this at home, make sure you don't stop anybody's circulation. I'm going to get out of the way, say ready, steady, go. All you've got to do is untangle yourselves. Okay?
Okay.
Ready, steady, go!
Shall I step?
Yeah. Okay. Go on. Do you want to... You were?
No.
I can't see. And then
how am I meant to get...
Try going up.
Up.
One of you going up through the loop.
Up through the loop.
Will that work?
I'm going to go up and around you. Yeah. I think maybe we were going to pass us back in the position we just got into, but...
We'll just make it twisted.
Oh, goodness, it doesn't matter.
You spin.
Which way is
it?
Okay, then the steps.
Well, they seem really stuck. I wonder if there is a way of doing it, or whether they're going to be like this the rest of their lives. There is a way of doing this, but if you'd rather not know and like to work it out yourself, then look away or turn the sound down now. There is a secret to the way to do this, and Tia and Marshall are going to show it to us now. You make a loop of string, pass it through the cuff, over the hand, and step away. Hooray!
So you see, it was chewed through, and I'm trying to fix it.
Oh, Camilla, please forgive me. I'm so sorry. I appreciate now you were trying to help. I really do apologise. Seems Taylor and his friends were getting a bit tangled up too.
Ah, there you are! More clues!
Oh, good.
Yes, we ventured into the pyramid and we found these. A cloak and some handcuffs. What on earth did you make of those then, chaps?
No idea.
Terry was just playing about with some handcuffs.
Oh, yes, we've got time for playing about now. We've got to get these over to Angeline at the finds table. Oh.
Well, these clues are very interesting. I wonder if they link with the book that we found yesterday. Do you remember? Berenshit, beginning. And we said it was a book from the beginning of the Bible, Genesis. Let me see if I can find in our book. Oh yes, here we are. We can pick up the story where we left off. Yesterday, do you remember, it was a messed up family with favourites and jealousy and hatred, and it ended with Jacob the dad thinking that his favourite son Joseph had been killed by a wild animal, when really he's been sold by his brothers and taken to Egypt. Now, he was just 17 years old when this happened. He was just a teenager, just a boy. And here he is, been taken off to a country he'd never been to before. When the traders arrived in Egypt, they sold Joseph as a slave to a man called Potiphar, the captain of the palace guard. Now, yesterday, Joseph came across as a bit full of himself, a bit foolish, but it's been a long journey to Egypt from where he lived. He's had a lot of time to think, and he's changed a lot already. He's gone from being his dad's favourite, who didn't have to do as much work as the rest of the family, to now being a slave who's got to do exactly what he's told when he's told. He could have moaned, he could have grumbled about it, but he didn't. He works hard, and God is with him, and he makes Joseph successful at everything he does, which meant that things work out for Potiphar too. And Potiphar is so pleased with Joseph that he made him his personal servant and put him in charge of all the other staff and everything that Potiphar owned. Potiphar didn't have to worry about anything in his home because Joseph had it sorted. Potiphar was good to Joseph, and God was good to Potiphar. Wherever we are, whatever we do, we can show people that we're God's friends by the way that we act. We don't want to do anything that would give people a reason to say or think bad things about God. If we say that we're a friend of God but we're lazy and we don't work hard, then that doesn't make God look good, does it? And if we moan when things don't go our way, that doesn't make God look good. Joseph worked hard, even though it was an unfair situation that he was in. And because of that, people saw that God was with him. So, a terrible situation for Joseph has been made a little bit better, but things are about to take a turn for the worse again. Joseph was a good-looking young man. He was strong and he was handsome. And after a while, Potiphar's wife began to notice him, and she liked what she saw. She kept pestering him to come to bed with her, and Joseph knew that would be really wrong. She was married to Potiphar, she was another man's wife, and Potiphar trusted him. He couldn't do that. She was someone else's wife, and that meant that she was off limits to Joseph. But Mrs. Potiphar was very persistent. She kept on and on at him, and she wasn't used to people saying no to her. One day, there was no one else around, and she found Joseph and grabbed him by his cloak. And Joseph was pulling away, and as he pulled away, he got out of the cloak, and the cloak was left in Mrs. Potiphar's hands. He ran away as fast as he could. She was really cross, so she screamed and called out to her servants, "Joseph just tried to attack me. When he came near me, I screamed, he ran away, but look, he's left his cloak." When Potiphar heard what his wife said that Joseph had done, he was really angry. He arrested Joseph and he had him put in prison. Surely now Joseph is going to complain and grumble, because he did the right thing. He did what God would have wanted him to do, and it still ended up terrible. But he doesn't moan about it being unfair. God was still with him. And even while he was in prison, Joseph worked really hard. He got on with the tasks that he was given to do. And he didn't moan, he didn't grumble, and the prison warden saw something different in Joseph. So much so that he put him in charge of all the prisoners. He was still a prisoner, but he had an important role. Which makes me think that doing the right thing doesn't always mean that things will immediately be okay. Sometimes God lets tough things happen because he's got a bigger plan. He might have things that he needs us to learn, or he might need us to deal with difficult and sometimes unfair things to get us where he needs us to be. in the right place at the right time. So why might God want Joseph in prison? I think we need to keep digging for clues and see if the beginning book can tell us more tomorrow.
Goodness me, you know, Joseph must have been so cross and angry with Mrs. Potiphar. That lie she told, that was dreadful. But you know, God asks all of us to be prepared to forgive each other. And the reason we do is because in Jesus Christ, God is able to forgive us. So we're going to sing our next song, You Forgive Me.
Around where you are. Plenty here in Egypt, but Terry's going to show you now how you can make one at home.
Well, good morning. I'm joined today by my assistant, Dexter. Now, Dexter, we've been very interested in the story of Joseph. And you're quite keen on Lego, aren't you?
Yeah.
You love building in Lego. Yeah. So what have we got here?
A Lego pyramid.
A Lego pyramid. And where do we find pyramids?
In ancient Egypt.
So this is a model of what we find in ancient Egypt, pyramids. And why were they built? Why did they build pyramids?
So the pharaohs and parts of the family could be put in there.
What, when they died?
Yeah, when they died.
And they kept them there. Right. Well, that's very interesting. The original ones were made of stone. But did you know that you can make a pyramid out of sand? Yeah? Should we have a go? Yeah. What do we need?
We need a tub.
Yeah, it's got to be square. Must be square tub. The squarer the better. So put that down there. And are you going to help fill it up?
Yeah.
Right, now we pour it in. Will it go? No, it's not pouring. I think it's a bit wet, this sand. Yeah. Oh, will it make a pyramid? No, not quite. Ah.
We might need to angle it with our hands.
Yeah. Yes, it's just a bit too wet to make, isn't it? Right. Ah, that's not so good, is it? Yeah, that's what it should look like. But you need really dry sand. We haven't got dry sand. I wonder what else we could use. Let's try it with something different, like sugar. How do you think that's going to go, Dexter? That's much more like a pyramid, isn't it? That's really quite good. In fact, Dexter, you can use anything so long as it's got a regular shape and flows very easily. The sand we used was slightly wet, but if you've got dry sand, it will work. You can use sugar, but you know, you can use one of these.
Peas.
What sort of peas?
Frozen peas.
Frozen peas. We can use frozen peas. So are you going to help me pour these in and see what happens? Do we get a nice regular pyramid? Yeah, that's not bad.
Kind of, yeah. Maybe we could just have one pea on top and it would be kind of...
better, you think? Just a few more on top. Yeah, just a bit slower. But do you notice, compared with the sugar, the pyramid is not so steep. Now, I wonder why that is. You can have a think about that at home. But experiment with what you can use to make a pyramid.
Yes.
Who knew you could make a pyramid out of peas? Sam's going to come now and help us with the memory verse.
So, we're going to learn a bit more of our Bible verse this morning. Yesterday we finished on the word God, waiting to see what God would do. Although Joseph was sold as a slave, he ended up in a really good position, being treated really, really well by Potiphar. And then things seemed to go wrong again when Potiphar's wife lied. And now he's ended up in prison. But God can still use those evil, bad things for good. When people hurt us, they mean to cause us harm and can make things difficult for us or sad. But God can turn that upside down for us and turn it into something good. So the next part of our Bible verse is, turned your evil into good. So if we put that all together, it's, you meant to hurt me, but God turned your evil into good. So I will just remind you of the signs from the bit that we learnt yesterday, which were, you meant to hurt me, but God. And then I will teach you the next bit, which is, turned your evil into good. So let's put that all together. You meant to hurt me, but God turned your evil into good.
Okay, Camilla, so how does it go again? You meant to hurt me, but God... Oh, that's right. Turned your evil. Oh, that's right. With the little fingers, yeah. Your evil into good.
Ah, how did you get on? It's very good having those signs to help us remember, isn't it? Keep trying. Marshall and Tia, I've got another craft for you now. I hear you could also be looking like ancient Egyptians.
Hello everybody and welcome back to day two of the craft for the week. Today we'll be making part one of our Egyptian costume, which are cuffs, and they'll be going on our wrists. So things you will need for this craft are a pair of scissors, a glue stick, tissue paper, mosaic tiles, some jewels, and some glue tabs. You'll also need toilet roll, which hopefully you have already got at home. If not, you can use just a rolled up bit of paper or a toilet, like a kitchen roll that you can just cut in half. So, the first thing you are gonna need to do is grab your toilet roll and cut one line through your toilet roll as Tia will show us. Now hopefully, once you've cut this, it will just fit nicely around your wrist. Just like that, what a model. Perfect. So once you've done it to one, you're gonna do this exactly the same thing to the other one. There we go. The next thing we are gonna do is we are just gonna get that gold tissue paper and we are going to fold it in half first, like Tia has already done, and then we're gonna cut it. And we're just gonna cut it in half down the middle. So when Tia has finished cutting it, hopefully we'll have two pretty even bits of gold tissue paper. Just like that. Amazing. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put one bit of tissue paper down on the table and the other one we are going to start wrapping around our cuff. We're gonna use our glue stick to stick the tissue paper to the cuff or the toilet roll. Once you've covered it in glue, you are going to grab your tissue paper and wrap it around your toilet roll. Just gonna smooth it up really, really nicely. And if you have any excess or extra tissue paper you don't need, you can either wrap it around the inside of your tube or really, really carefully try and cut away the bits you don't need. So Tia has just cut some of the gold tissue paper off, so she has just a little bit left for the edges. And what she's gonna do is she's gonna grab her glue stick and she's just gonna glue the inside of the toilet roll now, just on the edges, and then she's gonna fold over the tissue paper so it looks kind of more level and smooth and even. She's gonna do that to both sides. And then once she's done that, she's gonna do it to the top and the bottom ends of the toilet roll. Perfect. Oh, it's looking great already. There we go. So once you've done it to one toilet roll, you're just going to copy the exact same thing with the other one. So once you have covered your toilet rolls in the lovely golden tissue paper, the next thing we are going to do, which is the most exciting part, is we are going to get decorating. So with our mosaic tiles and our lovely shiny magical jewels, we are going to decorate them in any way you'd like to. So Tia is just going to start decorating And with the jewels, we have some glue tabs, just to make sure they really do stay on, because they might be a bit wobbly or might fall off. So we're just going to stick our glue tabs on, just to make sure they don't fall off. If you need any help, remember you can ask an adult at home or an older sibling to come and help you out. So you can decorate it any way you like, take as much time as you need. Again, if you want to pause it, feel free. And you can just make it look as lovely and as beautiful and as royal as you'd like it to. And then once you have finished decorating it to kind of the level you're happy with, we're going to have another Blue Peter moment. We've prepared one earlier, so once you're happy with the way it looks, they should look a little something like this. And Tia is very kindly going to model them for us now. So once you have finished, you can just put them on your wrist and you are ready to be royally cuffed. Look at you and your lovely cuffs. So guys, I hope you have enjoyed making your craft today, and we will see you tomorrow for your next craft. See you later. Bye.
So in today's story, Joseph finds himself in prison. But he needs to remember that no matter what he is facing, God will always be with him. And I think that's a very good reminder for us too.
Woke up this morning feeling kinda blue, a little sad but I know just what to do. Oh 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 oh. I have learned that I can go to Jesus. He lifts me up whenever I need it. Oh oh. Keeps my spirits high no matter what I'm facing.
We're going to show some of the pictures that you send us, and here's today's selection. It seemed as if writing on the clay tablet was very, very popular. It required quite a lot of concentration and careful inscribing. You're not much help if you fall asleep, but at least I can concentrate. Wow, seeing yourself as others see you. On this TV, Professor Potty seems almost bigger than real life. Could be scary. Ah, we're ready for action to go into a lovely song. What a beautiful coloured coat that's been made here. No prize for guessing who this is. Beautifully executed. Patience, though, is needed. Look at the concentration. And this is one of your lovely memory verse coats that we've seen. Really great. Thank you for all your pictures.
Well, chaps, it's the end of day two and the clues are really stacking up, aren't they?
Absolutely brilliant. And that teaching, I mean, Joseph, the poor guy, it's been so unfair on him. His brother's stringing, and then Mrs. Potiphar.
But yes. The
amazing thing is, he doesn't get angry and frustrated. He just keeps on steady, trusting in God. Absolutely fantastic.
Yeah.
Maybe that's a good point for us as we finish today to say a prayer for ourselves.
Yeah,
let's
good
let's
idea.
Pray together.
Good idea.
And Lord, we all know what it's like when things are unfair. But help us to trust in you. Help us, like Joseph, to keep on going step by step. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Very good indeed. Yes, now, you've got lots to be getting on with, chaps, haven't you? Activities, crafts, games, and songs. Don't forget, though, you've got to send your photographs in of all the things that you've been up to. 4:30, no later, mind. Dr. Sandifoot, did you get to the bottom of what happened in your tent?
No, I didn't. And I'm so sorry, because it wasn't Camilla, and I've been to see her and I've apologised. I'm sorry I got so cross.
Well, yes. So you don't know.
I've no idea. Mystery. It is a complete mystery.
Well, we'd better get off then, chaps. We'll see you tomorrow. Toodle-pip.
Cheerio.